Welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now let's head down to the coin toss. It's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste and zero calories. Enjoy everything. Southern Miss is kicking off first, and we're ready to get this game underway. And he got all of this one. Great kick. And they can forget about returning this one. So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. They come out in a goal line set. Strings it out left, and he stopped right away. So it's second and 10. Ball in the 25. Tackle at the 25-yard line. No gain. That brings us third and 10. And he's going to be sacked for a loss. He just blew past the blockers and dragged the quarterback down.
Boy, excellent play by the defense here. A few extra seconds, and those receivers might have been open.
And that's three and out. Nothing going on that series. Fourth and long here after the sack. And they're coming after this punter. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. So the offense will come out in opponent's territory for their first drive of the game.
They couldn't have asked for better field position than this.
Tackled after decent pickup.
That brings him second and five.
And down he goes at the 44-yard line. Third down now. They need to get it down to the 34. It's a fumble. Scoops up the loose ball. He's at the 20. He scores. What a play.
Defensive touchdowns give teams such a big morale lift. This is a really nice play to grab the loose ball and take it the distance.
They're going to review this fumble, and I've got to tell you, I think he was down before the ball popped loose.
I don't know about this one, Brad. They called it a fumble on the field, and they need indisputable video evidence to overturn this call.
After review of the play, the rule on the field is reversed.
So after the review, they reverse the call on the field. So they're going to go for it here. Rifles it right side. Nice catch on that one. Huge gain, and that sets him up nicely with a first and goal.
Well, you give up too many passes like that, and the game will be done before you know it. They cannot let these receivers get behind them.
He gets rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
They're at the two. It's second down. And he tackles him hard at the two.
No good on the play. That makes us
They're packed in tight on the line. Dives forward. The running back gets a yard, maybe less. So from a yard out, the offense is going to try to stay on the field here on fourth down and goal. The Golden Eagles running back taken out earlier, sidelined with that injury. However, it looks like he's going to be able to come back in this game. Room around the corner. Touchdown, Southern Miss.
That was a very good all-around effort. The running, the blocking, the entire package. A well-deserved score.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. A nice seven-play, 37-yard drive, and that's good for a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
So our score, 7-0. Golden Eagles are looking downright scary on defense so far, Herbie.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive.
Well, it's one thing to have speed. It's another thing to have an idea of what you're doing, how to attack the defense. And right now, these wide receivers clearly have done an outstanding job in being able to make their reads and getting out of their breaks, and the quarterback put the ball right on the money.
They line up in the jumbo set. And they make the stop at the 41.
Gain of 2 yards. That makes it second and eight.
It's second down and eight. Ball on their own 41. The 49. So the completion goes for about 8 yards and a first down.
It's the protection up front that allowed this play to happen. The line controlled the rush, and it gave the quarterback an opportunity to deliver a very nice throw.
And the quarterback didn't waste any time getting rid of that one. He took the snap, and he threw it right out there. Good tackle there in space. They move the sticks after another first down.
Impressive drive by this offense so far. I really like what they're doing by keeping this defense on their heels and moving the ball downfield.
From the 40-yard line, first down. He's at the 30. Makes it to the 17. Tackled at the 3-yard line. First and goal, and if they can execute, we'll be all tied up. Touchdown, Stanford! Nice run and a score.
Call by the coach there. Just give it to your main man anytime you're near the goal line.
The extra point to tie this game up, and he adds the extra point. So that's a 7-play, 75-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 32.
Both teams are kind of struggling to take control of this game. Obviously, they're both very, very competitive with one another. It just seems that the lead is going back and forth between the two teams.
And as the defense comes back out, you can be sure they're thinking about that score they surrendered the last time around.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now, it's really paying off. He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
Right, Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Here they come. And he's immediately tackled. He might not be able to get the pass off. He throws a dart to the left. From the 31-yard line, second down. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. And a quick throw. They come out in a five wide set. Here's the give. Tackle made at the 7-yard line. From the 7-yard line, second down.
Okay, just like that. Just like that.
Red 18! Red 18!
Throws complete, touchdown. Receiver for the score.
And the closer you get to the end zone, the more difficult it becomes to throw the football because the field becomes much smaller to work with. But they did a very nice job there to come up with the touchdown.
He makes the PAT. The scoreboard lit up in that first 15 minutes. The Golden Eagles lead 14-7. Southern Miss lines up for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer. And that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
Welcome back here. We resume action now here in the second quarter. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They come out in a goal line set. He's to the 40.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
From their own 49-yard line, it's first down. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. He steps out at the 47.
That makes it 7-6.
First and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. They're packed in tight on the line. He makes it to the 38-yard line. Makes it to the 35-yard line. They're about 4 yards away here on third down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. And now he's got room to run. And he will score. through with a score.
Well, this is what separates good backs from great ones. You have to have the ability to contribute to the passing game.
Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. And he hits the PAT. It was a six-play, 75-yard drive, and they come away with 7 points. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Just amazing, Herbie. We've seen four straight possessions now in which the offenses have scored.
You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. He's hit and taken down.
That's a heads-up play there by the defender. Get those hands up and something good may just happen.
From their own 46-yard line. Second down. So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. They hand it off. Makes it out to about the 46. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. Fires to his tight end, nothing doing.
I'm not going to fault that decision. It was definitely a first down that they could have picked up. You want to be aggressive early on, even if it doesn't always work out.
Not much of a problem getting the ball in the end zone on their last drive as this quarterback just picked apart the defense.
Well, I think this defense has got to do something because right now the quarterback is in such a good rhythm that you've got to do something to try to get him out of it. I would suggest trying to bring more pressure. Try to come up with an exotic blitz look to try to get him on his heels as opposed to being the aggressor and attacking the defense.
So it's second down, and they're only about a foot away from picking up the first down. They put everyone up on the line. Takes it right, and he can't get back to the line. He's taken down around the 46-yard line. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They're all tied in on the line here on fourth and short. To about the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, first down. Looks like someone got a head start on the line.
False start, offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
Not a great throw by the quarterback, but to be fair, that was pretty good coverage.
Second down, and they've got 15 for the first down. Ball on the 49. He's out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
Everything about that play was crisp. The route, the throw, the catch. That's fun to see.
Give himself a chance. The only problem is, at some point, you've got to have a feel, almost that sixth sense on when to get out of there and avoid the pressure, or just to throw the ball before you get hit.
He gets it away, and this is a really nice punt. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. Throws this one away. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 20.
Mike 17, Mike 17.
And he's going to be sacked for a loss.
Man, these guys can be aggressive. When you stand back there and take hits like that, you definitely are going to feel it the next day.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
You know, great effort here by the ball carrier, but I think they need to pass in that situation most of the time.
They'll bring him down to the 47-yard line. You always want to go in the locker room with momentum, so as we get closer to halftime, I think we'll see more and more attempts to create big plays. Makes the grab and steps out right away. Excellent play as the quarterback found his receiver for a big game.
Well, give credit here to the receiver for finding that seam and coming up with a nice game for the offense.
From the 32-yard line, first down. And down he goes around the 14-yard line. Quick throw, incomplete, blocked by his receiver. And he misses his wide receiver there.
Yeah, you're right. This is an area that he's worked so hard to improve since day one. The accuracy of his throws, he's improved. But as you can see, he's upset here with himself.
The kick is up, and it sails through the uprights. This return should be the last play of the half. He'll need to break it all the way to give his team the lead. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Hands it to the back. Runs it left for a decent gain. That's the end of the half, and believe it or not, folks, it's still anyone's ball game. 17-14, Stanford.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bruce Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. What a terrific first half. This is everything we anticipated this game being, and we're going to be riveted to this game, I feel like, David, in the second half, anticipating a terrific finish.
It's fun. It's living up to the hype every single time. We can't even turn the channel here. We got it on the big screen, on the big 60-inch. Yes, it's quite nice, by the way, too. The weather's nice and warm. It's beautiful. Got some chips. We're opening them up a little bit. But great game. Living up to the hype. It definitely feels like both teams are evenly matched. It feels like it can go either way. It feels like it's going to come down to the wire. And the only thing I hope it doesn't come down to is a kicker. Please don't come down to a kick in the end. Both these teams playing great D, playing great O, you know, physical, you know, pounding on each other, making big plays. Don't come down to a finesse kick by like a soccer player, please.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. He'll return it from the 4-yard line. Gets to about the 27-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. They'll make the sack.
Coaches don't like it when their quarterback gets hit like that. Don't be surprised to see the old coach get on his lineman to protect the quarterback a little bit better.
So the sack makes this a second and long. Going long. And he's got it. And they make the stop around the 24-yard line. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun, five wide receivers. He's scrambling. They'll bring him down at the 17. That scramble gets them 7 yards.
That'll bring up second and three.
Give to the tailback. The five. Touchdown, Southern Miss. Run by the halfback to find the end zone.
Good play call here by the offense coordinator. He realizes when you get down into the red zone and you have a halfback like this, just give him the ball and let him find his way into the end zone.
And he tacks on the extra point. A four-play, 73-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points.
Boy, that is scoring in a hurry. This offense is looking more and more explosive.
He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. On the ground, and he won't get back to the line.
That's a great play by the defense. There's nothing like a defense being able to slip off of a block, get into the backfield of the offense, and then make a play in the backfield to be able to create some momentum possibly for this defense.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Quickly to the tight end, and he's tackled at the 28-yard line.
That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That makes it third and seven.
Slings it out there incomplete.
You know, I think the quarterback got so excited to make this throw that I think he just put too much on the football. His receiver was open. He just misfired.
It to the 45-yard line. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
I love to watch a quarterback when he can really get into sync with his wide receivers. These guys have worked all week on their preparation to attack this defense, and right now it's really paying.
Southern Miss is up by 4. Fires. Great concentration to haul it in. And he's finally knocked out of bounds at the 13. Another catch, and he's up to 100 yards now.
Even when he isn't open, the quarterback will still throw him the ball and just let him make a play. It really shows the trust that the quarterback has with his receiver. Solid fundamental pass defense.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Brought down after a nice run up the middle.
Don't get tense down by the end zone. Sometimes a young quarterback will make a silly mistake or a receiver will come down with a case of stone hands, but not with this group.
He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He just drills this one. And it sails out of the end zone for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Tackle made at the 35-yard line. From their own 35-yard line, it's first down. He gets out to about the 38-yard line.
That'll make it second and seven.
From the 48-yard line, first down. He's at the 40, tackle at the 36. But he can't shake the defense.
That brings him second and goal.
From the 32-yard line, second down. And he's taken down at about the 33-yard line. They don't get back to the line of scrimmage there on the option keeper, a loss of one.
The smart quarterbacks and offensive linemen have a really unique relationship. A quarterback should take care of his offensive linemen. But after that play and that hit, you really got to be wondering what kind of relationship this quarterback and his offensive linemen have after that.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. Little too much leg into that punt. They'll bring it out to the 20. Their last drive ended with a touchdown. Let's see what happens on this possession.
You know, when this defense went over to the sideline, based on the way they've been playing so far, this defense coordinator has got to be living. He's got to get in their face. He's got to challenge them. He's got to get their emotions going. Because when you play defense, it's not just about X's and O's. It's about attitude and playing with a lot of confidence.
from their own 20-yard line. It's second down. Fires out to his receiver. Brought down at about the 31. They come out on an empty backfield. He's at midfield, and he's got it. He's taken down at the 48. Spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Here they come. Now he's scrambling. Slides down. A quarter to go, and can they pull the upset? 28-17, Golden Eagles. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He gets to about the 31-yard line.
This is the kind of steady, strong drive that coaches love to see. Right now, they're firing on all cylinders.
Set. Looks for his tight end over the middle. And down he goes. Right around the 14-yard line.
Just another weapon for this offense. He's got good hands, and he's tough to bring down. He showed right there that he can make something big happen.
There's a run up the gut, but nothing going there. Throw out to the receiver, incomplete.
I mean, he has his wide receiver wide open. You spend all those hours during the week to be able to get prepped and ready to go. You got an open man like this, just step and deliver and make the throw.
Pressure got to him and he put it on the ground. And they make the stop around the 13-yard line. It's fourth down. This one should be makeable. It's up, and it is good. Southern Miss, ready to kick this one off. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. Made at the 19. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it. They hand it off. Got an opening. And he shoved out of bounds at the 28. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one.
That brings us second and one.
Bring him down at about the 39-yard line. 50-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And he's tackled at about the 41. It's second down now, and they're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Here's a throw, and it's almost picked. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds. Quick throw to the tight end. And that sets them up with a first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First down. Defense trying to prevent any more damage. First and goal inside the five.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
It's the 11th play of the drive. Receiver, touchdown. What a time for that touchdown, and now they've still got a chance in this game. He makes the PAT. Tackled at the 45-yard line.
Illegal touching. Offense. Still first down.
A score here might effectively end this one. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. Run, left side. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line.
I like how efficient the offense looked on that play. Everybody knew their assignment, and it all came together for a nice run.
He's into the open field. And he's tackled after positive yardage. From the 49-yard line, second down. Makes it out to about the 40.
Very well designed play that time to give him a first down. The linemen executed their blocks nicely and it went for a good game.
Makes it out to about the 29. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line. Right for a nice game, and he keeps it on the option play and picks up six.
That'll make it second and four.
17's Mike, Mike 17. There.
Here we go. Red 18. Red.
pops it up the middle for a nice run. Oh, he's got a player down, and let's hope that's nothing serious. And this one's all but wrapped up. Golden Eagles get the victory, 31-24. So that wraps things up for us, 3A Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. I'm Brad Nessler saying thanks, and we'll see you next time.